Most of us feel that calcium supplements are very essential for bone health. Today, we're going to talk about vitamin D and its importance in bone health. ...90% of vitamin D is produced from the sunlight by chemical changes underneath our skin. But there are many reasons why we are vitamin D deficient. And I'm not sure if you'll be surprised that a country like India, where we get almost 365 days of sunlight, we are about 80 to 90% vitamin D deficient. Several studies have shown this, that children as young as 1 year are about 90 to 95% vitamin D deficient. Children about 18 years of age are about 70 to 80% deficient, and some adults are as much as from 40% to 97%. Some studies have shown vitamin D deficiency. So this is a very serious problem, because vitamin D is not only essential for bone health, but it's also important in many things in many parts of our body. For example, there's a high risk of autoimmune disease because it's a very important vitamin in the autoimmune cascade. It can cause cancer, heart attack, depression, and various other problems in our body. And you'll be surprised by this information. Now, in terms of bone health and vitamin D. Now, the calcium that we take in our diet or as supplements need to be absorbed by the body. And for this, vitamin D is very essential, and it increases 20 times more the absorption of calcium in our body. Well, how do we get vitamin D? One is, as I said, available free in the sun, and the exposure to sun is very important. Most Indians do not expose themselves to our sun. It is not cultural. We don't like to be in the sun. We don't like to get tanned because of our color. And so we protect ourselves, and also a lot of Muslims in our country wear the parda, which actually protects them from the sun. So it's very important that we expose ourselves to the sun in order to get enough vitamin D, because 90% of our body vitamin is made from the sun. When is the best time? Well, some studies say the morning sun, some studies say the evening sun, but really doesn't matter in my opinion. I think just get exposed to sun. People with lighter skin need only 15 to 20 minutes, whereas people with darker skin may need about 1 to 2 hours. So there's a lot of difference in that. Women are at more risk of developing vitamin D deficiency and need to expose themselves more. People living in the urban are more at risk of developing vitamin D compared to people in the rural because of one, their exposure to sun, and two is the pollution that covers the skin and the amount of UV rays that we get. So how do we get vitamin D apart from sunlight? So there are two ways in which we can supplement vitamin D. One is through the diet, and some of the diet that's very rich are, number one, fish like salmon, sardines, tuna, egg yolk, mushrooms, some green leafy vegetables, and also sometimes you can take fortified food in milk, cereals, oats, and various other things. The second is you can take cod liver oil or other vitamin D supplements or medication. There's a recommendation that about 600 to 1000 international units is required for somebody to maintain a dose, which can be taken either through diet or through supplements. So it's very important for you to be aware of the importance of vitamin D, and you don't need to spend too much money in doing tests or taking supplements. You just can get it free from being outdoors and enjoy the sun. Thank you.